Hi, this is Ricky Sun. I'm a PI consultant. In this video, I'm going to talk about what is PI data link and why it is important, as well as showing you how the data flow from one end to another in terms of architecture, to how data get to Excel. Sorry. Also, a demo of what PI data link is all about, right? So you can get familiar with this tool. So why do we want to use PI data link? From my opinion, PI data link has been around for a very long time. Actually, Excel, right, is a very common tool for finance, right, for accountant, for anyone who want to manipulate numbers. And PI data link is sitting on top of that. If we are able to inject the PI data into Excel, then the people who are using Excel will be beneficial. Like, for example, supply chain manager, they want to create a report every day in the morning so they can start working and predict what he need to order in terms of supply. He don't want to have too much inventory. He want to have, for example, enough inventory to keep the production going. So this is kind of like he wanted to have that report so that he is able to keep the plant running for the plant manager. That's one use case. And also recently, like from a PI admin also perspective, is I use PI data link to verify my data flow. I make sure my interface data are updating, and if they are not updating, I want to know why. If these need to be decommissioned, I want to decommission those tags, right? So data link is also a tool for PI administrator to look at the data to make sure everything's okay. And it is very fast, and I could have 10,000 tags and I verify very easy. In PI data link, and it's supposed to verify that in the PI system management tool, because it pulls data so fast and I could look at the data flow quickly. And let's talk about the architecture. So this is the architecture of how data get to Excel. You can have a SCADA system, and then the SCADA system have an add-on to become having OPC servers, and then you can buy a license from Fiva to collect the data through the PI interface. It could be connector, it could be adapter, and then send the data to PI server. That's where the storage is. And PI server have tags, and if you create an AF structure, you need asset framework. So this is asset framework where you can structure your data so you can find your data easier, or your other people find your data easier. After that, you just need to use the PI data link to get the data from the PI system and the AF server. So AF server, you could create event frame as well. The PI data link could look at event frame data as well. So this is kind of how data flow from one end to another. And I'm going to show you a real example of the demo. So what is PI data link in Excel? So this is Excel. If I press on this PI data link tab, this is PI data link, and it can help pull the real-time data into Excel sheets. It can update automatically, like if you press the update button. And very quickly, I want to show you some functionality, like the basics. First, right, the current value. So I'm going to type in like just a tags. Right, this is a sample tags, CDT158. I'm going to press this current value function, and on the right, you can see this is a current value function, and you can fill your data item, which you can type it in, but I'm going to reference it here. And then the output cell is going to be, for example, here, and I can make the time available as well. So this is kind of like you can get current value. And I forgot to show you, it is critical to make the connection to your PI server as well as AS server first. And here is where you do that connection. In PI data link, and then and settings, you have connection manager here. That's the button. And then you can see a list. If you don't have a list, you have to add it in. And then you can add it in based on IP or hosting. Your Pi server, as I said in the architecture, is not in the same network as your Excel machine. You might need to talk to IT to have a firewall hole open to be able to connect to it. Because if the firewall, let's say the Pi server is in the control network, your Excel is in corporate network, then it is not going to work at the first time. You need to talk to IT and be able to punch port called 5450 to get to the Pi server. And if your AF server is also in the control network, then same apply, it's except different port. That's a weird critical step. You need to be able to press connect like this. And I disconnect first, but I wanted to show you connect. Then you will be able to see like, oh, I have a user connected to my Pi server and AF server. So that's a critical step. Usually this is the biggest hurdle, have to work with IT. This is kind of like where people stop, like, oh, I cannot get my data, it's so difficult and I don't know how. I just show you the current value function, and I'm going to show you the compressed data function. What is it? Compressed data function is whatever is stored in your Pi server. If you use this function, then you could look at the data as it's in the Pi server store. So I'm going to press compress the data, and then I'm going to press this button. And then again, I'm going to reference my tags, but I don't have a start time and end time on my sheets, right? I can either fill it down here, or I can do a reference of a cell as well. So maybe I'm going to close it and then just type in a time. For example, I want today minus 1 day, and then today. T means today, and T minus 1 is 1 days ago from today. And T is also in the midnight of today. It's not now. Star is now, and I'm gonna have that time abbreviation video, and you can search online. Some other people are also having that. So let's press that compress the data function again, and I'm going to reference that, and start time is this one, end time is the T, and then output cell right here, and then show the timestamp. And then I got 286. And I wanted to show you in Pi system management tool under archive editor here, and if I do the same time, like T minus 1 day and then T, I just want to show you they will be matching the numbers, the events. 286, 286. They're basically the same because that's what compressed the data function do. Whatever data is in the Pi server also display as a compressed data function. And the last one I want to show you is calculate data. This function is pretty powerful because it helps you make the calculation quicker. Instead of you do it on Excel, so you can just utilize that. Press calculate data function. I'm going to reference here. I'm referencing a cell. And I want to say, like, I think it's a common mistake people just fill out this. If they are doing that, the report is not going to be dynamic. For example, if you want a report every day at 5 o'clock to be safe, you want to make the time to be now, right? Like today at past 5 a.m. Right? Then you could get a report every day with the same configuration. Calculate the data, and then this is optional. I'm not going to touch it, but I want to show you maybe just maximum, for example. I'll put it over here. So that's the maximum of this thing. If you scroll down, you will see 200. I could do a count, for example. As you can see, it's pretty easy to use. And yeah, that's count and then okay, right? Actually, I don't know what count means. I could try to count time based on, oh, so it's time weighted count. So what I need to do is I count the events, and it should be 286. So this is Carl, and this is Max, right? Very simple, right? As you can see, just a few minutes, you are able to pull data from the Pi system all the way to Excel. Very easy functionality. And you can also get the rendering data, right? If you have anomaly detection, you can get that in Excel, analyze your start time, end time of the event. And that's pretty much it. We have gone through what is PyDataLink and the architecture, as well as a demo, and what else do you want to see, right? And I think the reason why PyDataLink, in my opinion, is very popular tool. And I think since the Pi system, since they sold you the Pi system, I think PyDataLink is almost like, because of PyDataLink, you buy the Pi system. What other tool out there you can utilize to easily pull data in Excel, right? There isn't that many. You can have very performing data archive, right? Storage and all that. But you know, if I cannot see the data, the Pi server data, I mean, or other historian data, right? Then it's not going to be useful to have that historian. If the historian is able to help me like quickly visualize data, and now we can feed the data to AI and all that, then you know, that's where the power is. To end this, it is because the PyDataLink is able to quickly and easily give the data to the people who are able to generate reports and make magic happen. And that's why this is still the bestseller tool, I think. Thank you very much for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. I'll see you next week. Bye.